battle of I-75 on the basketball court today at Savage Arena. And while Bowling Green still enjoys an all-time series lead over their Northwest Ohio rival in women's basketball, the Rockets have ruled the rivalry of late, winning 11 of the last 12 meetings and 8 straight. Falcons' last win over Toledo coming almost 7 years ago. We head out to Savage Arena in the first quarter. Lexi Fleming and the Falcons looking to extend the lead, takes it the other way and dishes it off to Nyla Hampton for the score. Falcons out to an 8-2 lead. In the second, Sophia Wired on the wing finds Tatiana Davis, top of the key, drains the three. Rockets pull within 7. Fourth quarter, Fleming with it on the wing, drives the paint and dishes it off to Kenzie Lewis underneath for the bucket. Falcons in front, 59-42. Wired to Sammy McConowitz in the corner, knocks down the three and cuts it to a 12-point game, but Fleming responds right back at the other end. She finished with a team-high 21 points. Falcons win the battle of I-75 for the first time since 2014, defeating the Rockets 69-57.
I told the team after the game that I'm proud of them for a million reasons, but I'm really proud. I'm really proud of the kids that have stuck with us, you know, the kids that have been here for 3 years and have chosen to stay at Bowling Green and have chosen to continue to build this program. And tonight, you know, that win was a small reward, just a moment, and it's a small reward, but they're a huge part of us having that opportunity to have success tonight.
I think the tail of the game in this one is turnovers and putting them at the free throw line. We knew and we told our team before the game, you can't foul this BG team. They shoot 78% from the free throw line. You're just giving them points when you foul. And I thought early on what really hurt us is a couple of our key kids got in foul trouble. To have Q have to sit during that first half. But also just the 15 turnovers that equated to, I think, 21 points in the first half. You know, if you take away that first half, that second half we did a much better job. You know, we were right there. So our response to what happened the first half was good. But I was disappointed with the turnovers and the lack of execution that we had. But you got to credit BG's defense. They were aggressive. And I thought, you know, they kind of got us back on our heels. But it's a good lesson for us to learn at this point in the season.